In this video, we're looking at a normal mode on a vibrating string, and I can see that I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 antinodes here. So this is the n=5 normal mode. We're told the frequency of oscillation for this normal mode, that's 200 hertz. We know the total length of the string, that's 1.2 meters, and we're given the linear density of the string, 12.5 grams per meter. In part A, we're going to find the wave speed on the string, and then in part B, we'll find the tension. Now to get the wave speed, what we're planning to do here is use the wave speed formula, V equals F lambda, and I'll post a link to the video where that was first introduced. So what we need is the frequency of oscillation for the wave and the wavelength. And I can just look at the picture here and see how many wavelengths there are in 1.2 meters. There's one complete wavelength, two complete wavelengths, and a half. So I have 2.5 wavelengths, 2.5 lambda is equal to my total distance of 1.2 meters. I solve for lambda. And I get 0.48 meters for the wavelength. Then we just sub in to the wave speed formula. V is equal to F lambda, that's 200 hertz for the frequency of oscillation, 0.48 meters for the wavelength. And remember, a hertz is a 1/2 seconds. And so I end up with units of meters per second here, so this is good. And I arrive at my wave speed of 96 meters per second. Now in part B, we're looking for the tension in the string. So we have a formula relating the speed in the string to the tension in the linear density. And I'll post a link to the video where this was first introduced. And that's V equals square root of T over mu. Now we're trying to solve for T in this case. We have the wave speed and the linear density. So we're going to square both sides and then solve for T. I'll start by writing V squared equals T over mu. And then we just multiply both sides by mu and we've solved for T. So T is equal to mu V squared. We need to plug in mu in SI units, that's kilograms per meter. So shift the decimal point 3 times, I get 0.0125 kilograms per meter. And then we're multiplying that by the square of the wave speed, so 96 meters per second all squared. Into 3 significant digits, I get 115. And paying attention to the units here, I have kilograms. One factor of meters is going to cancel. When I square that meters per second, I end up with one surviving factor of meters in the numerator, and then I have divided by second squared. So my units are kilogram meters per second squared, which is indeed a newton, and I get a tension of 115 newtons in the string. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.